Sebei region, located in eastern Uganda, has faced a long-standing challenge of female genital mutilation, or FGM. FGM, deeply rooted in cultural and traditional practices, has been prevalent in this region for generations. Sebei communities have historically practiced various forms of female genital mutilation as part of the initiation rituals, cultural norms, and rites of passage, posing severe physical and psychological consequences for the affected individuals. Despite the harmful implications, FGM has persisted due to its deep integration into the cultural fabric of Sebei society. Recognizing the imperative need for a collective action, these youth activists have united to amplify their voices and advocate for reinforced efforts against FGM. Their focus extends to raising awareness and promoting community involvement to combat the deep-rooted issues, as Chelling at Gloria, a Global Youth Consortium country representative, explains.
We believe that if our government come in to support us and help us in strengthening our efforts in ending female genital mutilation, it will be of great impact. The policies that exist, but this actually needs to be strengthened.
Another critical concern raised by the youth was the perceived laxity of the justice system. He noted that addressing FGM requires a more robust legal framework and enforcement to ensure justice for survivors and deterrence for potential offenders. As the dialogue progresses, youth say the government should involve communities in decision-making processes and allocate funds to district community offices for campaign scaling.
And that means that the government needs to scale up and also give us a small portion, and also ensure that when they are doing budgeting, some money is given to the district community office to scale up their campaigns.
In a determined effort to combat the harmful practice of the female genital mutilation, Kapchora District is implementing comprehensive strategies aimed at fostering positive change within its communities. Cheptai Philith, the woman member of parliament for Kapchora District, emphasizes the urgency of enforcing the anti-FGM laws. Despite the deep cultured roots of FGM, she underscores the need for active police involvement in implementing the laws and calls upon the community to play a role in reporting any incidents.
Fight FGM and make sure that by 2030, it is not there. We need to ensure that all the girls go to school and the training should continue. Sensitization for the sergeants, those ones who cut the girls, should also continue because they are now doing it in hiding.
Onong Samuel, serving as the program's manager at ActionAid, says that the Eastern region has registered the decrease in FGM, and this positive change could be attributed to various factors, including increased awareness, community engagement, and possibly the implementation of legal measures against the practice.
And we got to realize that now the method has changed, whereby those days openly people will conduct it. But nowadays what they do, they basically use traditional birth attendants to conduct it.
He further says that the organization has emerged as a pivotal force in supporting youth and children, addressing issues that profoundly impact their lives, especially FGM and child marriages, through symposiums, and urge leaders to prioritize youth-related concerns and bring them to the forefront of region discussions.
We have actually realized there is a change, because we find some of the mentors come up themselves. With the structures we have, like male change agents, they actually talk to them, and at the end of the day, most of these women have actually stopped cutting. Only that now the cutters are being imported from Okotlan to come and conduct.
Report compiled by Rachel Nachuwala for the news.